In a few days' time, Major Tim Peake will become the first British astronaut in 20 years to blast into space. And like every other Russian rocket launch since the 1960s, these final few days are filled with good luck rituals and traditions, as our Moscow correspondent Sarah Rainsford has been finding out.
This is Yuri Gagarin, the first ever man in space. And because his flight in 1961 was so successful, crews ever since have copied many of the things he did in the hope that'll bring them luck. So before the crew go up in a real one of these, the Soyuz space capsule, there's a whole series of rituals that they have to go through, and Tim Peake is no exception. The first of them's already been done. The crew have planted a tree here in Baikonur. Yuri Gagarin did it first, and there's now a whole alley of trees as a living memory to all of those who've been up in space from here. And there's another way that the astronauts leave their mark, as Tim Peake himself told me before he came down here.
On our final morning, once we've prepared for space flight, we'll be in our flight costumes, and we'll sign the doors that we're each allocated a door in the Cosmodrome, Cosmonaut Hotel. So we'll each sign the doors of the Cosmonaut Hotel that we stay in.
With not long to go until launch day, the astronauts are now in quarantine to make sure that they stay healthy for their flight, but the traditions go on. On their last nervous night here on Earth before liftoff, they all sit down to a classic of Soviet cinema. On launch day itself, it's on with the spacesuits and they emerge to a Soviet rock song, a spaceman singing nostalgically about life here on Earth. And then before they climb into the Soyuz spacecraft, there's time for one final pit stop.
Gagarin requested a pee stop, basically, on the way to his first flight. So from that moment onwards, all the astronauts stop, we get off the bus, we undo our suits, we have a pee stop on the back tire of the bus.
When Yuri Gagarin was preparing for launch, he asked for music to be pumped into his headphones to calm his nerves ahead of the big moment. He got Russian love songs played to him. Now, Tim Peake has been able to choose his own music, and he selected three tracks to be played as he prepares to make British space history.
That was Sarah Rainsford there, and rest assured, you can watch Tim Peake's blast off live. You can see it on the BBC News Channel. It is happening next Tuesday morning, so you can follow it all. Now, back down to Earth, let's find out what's happening with the weather. Hello, Stav.